Oh, we've got a dead short somewhere.
300 kilometres from the South Australia coast, the Mooka Boys are racing to find another $27,000 to hit their season target before blistering summer temperatures shut them down.
The machines don't really like running in the heat, so, we're running on the edge of time.
But a faulty fan motor has stalled their operation.
We're in a tunnel. You can get a real build-up of carbon monoxide really fast, so we've got to make sure we've got good ventilation.
If the vent stops, we can't dig. All right, what's going on with that motor?
Hey, hang on, Lave.
Oi. Must be a blacklight was tripping it.
Yeah, all right.
Checking over all the leads. Turned out to be the blacklight keeps tripping the circuit. So, just fix that up and we'll get moving again.
Just having a quick look while Leif's taking the loads out just to make sure we're not coming across any trace in here.
Come on. And there's no way we can keep working without that. It does all the main work.
Probably in the truck, so I have to go up and dump that load and get him out again.
Yeah, I think the spike's fell in here, so we'll get cover when he dumps the dirt. I'll walk behind it so you can find the spike. And I'll run the bull. Bit tame this one, though.
Didn't see it fall out.
Those spikes are the main digging point of the machine. You know, without those spikes, we can't dig properly.
All good?
No.
It's back in there then still?
No.
Oh, man.
It has to be in here somewhere. Hopefully.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, he's on the side. Oh, look at that.
Hey.
It's not opal, but that's the next best thing.
Cool.
Oh, hang on.
We've packed off one of the housings that hold onto a spike. So, I think we're going to have to get an oxy, some welders, and come back and put some heat and weld into this.
We got hot weather coming in hard now. Poor Lave's gonna have to do some grinding and some welding out there.
Not as good as a Boilermaker's weld, but it'll work.
Oi!
It's like a new one. You beauty, man.
Oh,
that's all we had to do, eh? We'll see you back down the hole. All right,
mate.
Oh! Boys, we got some rocks falling!
We've had a bit of dry weather here. We've got a few rocks crumbling out the walls of the open cut. It's a little bit dangerous to be poking a stick over the wall and a bit dangerous to be putting a ladder up.
You think you'll be able to do it with that?
I think so, mate. We'll have a good hot red crack at it anyway.
Matty got his gun licence a fair while back now, and I always make fun of him. No point having that, because they just sit in the safe, but now he actually got to use them.
The Mooka Boys have just days before extreme summer temperatures shut down their operation.
It's going to be loud.
They're desperate to prove the new three-man mining team can succeed.
It's pretty hard to keep a partnership together. It's really important for me and Cozzy to show Lave that we're up to the challenge. Yeah, some drop down there.
That's a good start.
Drop the beer. go. That's just about got it, eh?
Ah, wicked.
Awesome.
We're about 18 foot into the target now, so we're getting really close. You're starting to see evidence of silica coming into the level, so hopefully the further we go, the more we'll find.
Yeah, we've got some little pieces of opal up here, though. We've come across our first little seam of potch. Yeah, as we keep going in, we might get a better result.
At least it's material now.
Yeah, we actually found some opal at least. We're in the right place.
Making this 90 degree turn was a good choice for us because there wasn't much ahead of us. So, we'll see.
I think you're smoking out the back here, mate.
No. Oh, it is steaming out, man.
Oi. Jesus.
Oh, yeah, that's a good leak.
But that is not good. It's really not good. Diesel on the hot motor. That could potentially burn the machine down, and that's not good.
We can't have diesel leaking all over the back of the engine, particularly around the turbo. It could easily start a fire here. And yeah, we're a long way from any sort of help.
I think we might have to take this thing home, mate, because it's coming from around the back of the head.
Yeah, that's not good, man. That's
gonna pull the exhaust out, the intake, everything like that.
Yeah, and that's too dangerous, man. We really don't need a fire or this thing burning down.
Yeah, well, this is harder to solve the bloody whole show.
Is that barber going, bro?
Yeah, it's coming along nicely, mate.
How about a beer?
Yeah, I'll have a beer.
Awesome. Thank you. Mate, want a beer?
Yeah, I'll try.
Yeah, sweet. Unfortunately, in the last few weeks, we've just had issues just ramping up on us. So it's getting to the point where all the machines really need a good go over. It's getting way too hot out here. We've got crumbling walls, we've got flies all over the place. And it's a good time to call it, I think.
The Mooka Boys have been forced to stop mining, finishing their first season as independent miners using Leif's claim and equipment.
I hope Leif will offer us back for another season. The relationship's going good with him. I'll be here next season if he'll have me, that's for sure.
It's been a good season working with you, Leif, mate. Appreciate everything, eh?
Yeah, no, same, mate. It's been good.
Yeah, absolutely love being out here open mining, even with all the troubles, man.
So does that mean you're going to have us back next season?
Oh, yeah, we've got to finish what we started.
Yeah, excellent, man.
I'm in, man. I'm in for sure. Maybe next time we'll find our big win, eh?
I reckon I got something that'll keep you interested, eh?
Yeah?
Have a look at this.
Holy hell, man.
There were parts found by a friend of Dad's, not too far from here on the next field.
That's got some nice red in it, man. That's a nice little bundy there. This is a quartz rock.
Yep.
Whoa. We got access to this field?
Well, it was a friend of Dad's that was working down there, and he's getting a bit older and going to retire.
Really?
But he showed us a few spots around there where he got this sort of stuff.
Okay.
You like them?
Yeah, beautiful, mate.
Have a look at this. He's the big brother.
Holy hell, are you kidding me?
God!
That is a serious slab of opal, man.
That's the reason I want to go looking in this spot.
That's all quartz as well?
Yeah.
Holy
natural dark opalized quartz.
Opalized quartz, such as this one, can be worth tens of thousands of dollars for a pristine specimen.
That is the biggest chunk of quartz opal I've ever seen.
Look at the colour in it, mate.
It's an example of what Antivigo has to offer around here. The barbecue at the end of the day was a perfect opportunity to reveal these stones to the boys, and, you know, just show them that they're still these sorts of pieces out here. And yeah, that's one of the things Andamook is famous for, these big, large, unique pieces.
What does this weigh?
7.8 kilos. 37,000 carats.
One piece.
Right. Future's looking good, you know? I was just starting to think that maybe there isn't any opal left, but he pulls out pieces like that, there's definitely opal left, mate. Definitely.
So I'm helping the bloke to sell it.
Wow.
Yeah, he's going to show us the area that he got this.
Good work, Leif. Yes,
I think we got some good things coming.
I'm keyed as, mate.